In a world without sunlight, life has been igniting its own impossible lights for over 100 million years, long before the first dinosaur vanished. Yet nearly every deep-sea creature possesses this unnatural glow. If these alien signals can pierce absolute darkness, what secret struggle forced nature to evolve light here at all? And are we even close to understanding why? Bioluminescence did not arrive in a single burst of innovation. Instead, it has surfaced again and again, scattered across the tree of life like constellations in the abyss. More than 40 separate lineages, fish, jellies, worms, and even crustaceans, each found their own way to summon light from chemistry. This is not the product of a lone ancestor, but the result of evolution's relentless experiments, running for over 100 million years in the world's most hostile shadows. Yet the fossil record offers almost nothing. These creatures are built of soft tissue, their light organs vanishing into mud and silt long before bone or shell could preserve a trace. What remains is a puzzle reconstructed from genetic blueprints and the living signals pulsing in darkness. Molecular clocks ticking inside the DNA of lanternfish, dragonfish, and comb jellies trace the origins of glowing proteins back to a time when continents were still drifting apart. The sheer number of independent origins is staggering. Bioluminescence has become one of the most widespread adaptations in the deep, present in up to 90% of species below the reach of sunlight. Each lineage, armed with its own molecular toolkit, has solved the challenge of making light in a cold, crushing world. But why did this trait arise so many times? And what does it take to ignite a glow where no sun has ever shone? The answer is buried in the chemistry of life itself, waiting to be uncovered. Edith Widder drifted alone in the dark, her submersible lights switched off, surrounded by a silence broken only by the gentle hum of the deep. In her early expeditions, every attempt to document bioluminescent life failed. The moment a spotlight pierced the water, the ocean's glowing creatures vanished, leaving only empty blackness behind. Standard cameras and strobes, designed for shallow reefs, turned the deep sea into a stage with no actors. Widder's breakthrough came from a simple realization. To witness nature's light, she had to erase her own. She engineered the eye in the sea camera, a device built to vanish into the background, using sensors so sensitive they could record a single photon. Instead of blinding beams, her camera waited in total darkness, invisible to the life around it. Her first true success arrived off the coast of Florida in 2004. The eye in the sea captured an atolla jelly spiraling through the water, unfurling a blue halo that pulsed like a living signal. For the first time, a human observer watched the deep sea's natural light show unfold, undisturbed and unedited. The footage revealed not just the glow, but the choreography, patterns, and flashes that hinted at a language still unknown. Widder's invention marked a turning point. The deep's secrets would not be forced into the open. They had to be invited patiently on the creature's own terms. Her work opened a new frontier, not just seeing the glow, but understanding how it is made, molecule by molecule, in the cold and crushing dark. Inside a darkened laboratory, a vial of seawater sits beneath a glass dome. Gloved hands inject a clear solution, and a faint blue glow spreads instantly through the liquid. This is the heart of bioluminescence, a chemical reaction that turns darkness into signal. The key players are luciferin, a small organic molecule, and luciferase, a specialized enzyme. When luciferin meets oxygen in the presence of luciferase, the reaction drives luciferin into an excited state. As it relaxes, it releases a photon, a particle of light. The result is visible energy from a process invisible to the naked eye. Most deep-sea creatures rely on a form of luciferin called coelenterazine, which can be synthesized from scratch or scavenged from prey. The enzyme luciferase is tailored by each species, fine-tuned by evolution to function in near-freezing water and under pressures more than 8,000 times greater than those at the surface. In some animals, oxygen flow is tightly controlled, allowing them to turn their glow on or off in a fraction of a second. The light is produced in specialized organs known as photophores, tiny, lens-like structures embedded in skin or tissue, each acting as a miniature lamp. This chemistry is not just a curiosity of the abyss. The same luciferase genes, isolated from deep-sea organisms, now power biomedical imaging, tracing cancer cells and tracking gene expression in living tissue. But in the ocean, the reaction is not for human eyes. It is a tool for survival, honed by natural selection and shaped by the limits of physics. The next question is how each species has adapted this basic glow to their own needs: camouflage, communication, or predation, crafting a living language of light from a single spark. At 200 meters, the last rays of sunlight fade, giving way to the twilight zone. Here, lanternfish drift in schools, each carrying rows of photophores along their bellies and flanks. When a predator approaches from below, these tiny lights flicker on, matching the faint glow from above. In an instant, the lanternfish erases its own shadow, vanishing into the background. This is counter-illumination, a living cloak of invisibility. Deeper still, at 1,000 meters, the world enters the midnight zone. No sunlight reaches this far. Comb jellies glide through the water, their bodies lined with shimmering cilia. Some flash waves of blue-green light, confusing predators and signaling to others of their kind. Others, like the firefly squid, produce synchronized bursts of light from hundreds of photophores, creating a curtain of blue that ripples through the dark. These displays are not random. They are precise, timed, and often unique to each species. Dragonfish patrol the depths with a different strategy. Along their jaw and beneath each eye, specialized photophores emit a deep red glow. To most ocean life, this light is invisible. But the dragonfish can see it, using this private wavelength to hunt and communicate without alerting rivals or prey. In 1983, scientists confirmed that dragonfish possess unique visual pigments, allowing them to detect red light in a world tuned almost entirely to blue. At 4,000 meters and beyond, pressure reaches 8,000 times what is felt at the surface. Proteins and enzymes that drive bioluminescence here are built for extremes, stable, flexible, and active at just a few degrees above freezing. Survival in these depths is not just about making light, but making it work under conditions that would crush or freeze almost any other form of life. Each adaptation is a solution to a different problem: camouflage, hunting, signaling, escape. Yet even the most effective strategies sometimes reveal new mysteries, patterns, and flashes that science still cannot decode. A taller jelly drifts through the black, trailing a spiral of blue flashes that ripple outward in perfect circles. When threatened, it unleashes a burst of light so sudden and intense that even robotic cameras struggle to keep up. Scientists call it the burglar alarm. No two displays are identical. Some last less than a second. Some loop again and again, flooding the water with signals that no human fully understands. Nearby, the bloody belly comb jelly glows with a deep, impossible crimson. In a world where nearly all bioluminescence is blue, its light slips through the dark, nearly invisible to most predators. Siphonophores, long colonial chains stretching meters through the abyss, coordinate waves of light across dozens of individual bodies. Each pulse travels down the line, synchronized but unexplained. A living signal relay lost to science. These creatures break the rules, rewriting what light can do in the deep. 75% of all deep-sea animals can glow, but even among the millions, some displays remain beyond explanation. At MBARI, researchers now train artificial intelligence on thousands of hours of deep-sea video, searching for patterns in the flashes and spirals of light. Early findings suggest that some Atolla and bloody belly comb jellies repeat certain bursts when they gather, yet no one has cracked the code. The language of light remains undeciphered. a living cipher in the dark. At the same time, proposals for deep-sea mining threaten to erase species and chemistries before they are even named. Conservationists warn that the same zones mapped for rare metals are home to the richest bioluminescent life. Meanwhile, NASA oceanographers test sensors built for Europa's icy seas, inspired by the deep's chemical beacons. What we learn here may teach us how to listen beneath alien ice. The search for meaning and for protection now spans from the abyss to distant worlds. We still decode only fragments of the language written in light beneath the waves. With 75% of deep-sea species glowing, each signal could hold clues to new medicines, technologies, or even life beyond Earth. In the dark, the unknown is not empty. It is alive and waiting to be understood.